Enrique Jorquera Guerrero, El Jorquero, was a former ministerial police officer who became affiliated with cartels to carry out organized crime. He was a former ministerial liaison of the mafia with corrupt elements of the prosecution. Want to know how such a big wig in government became a name associated with criminals and violent crimes? Then sit back, relax, and watch the video until the end. What's Enrique Jorquera Guerrero's El Jorquero backstory? There's barely any information about Enrique Jorquera Guerrero, El Jorquero, in the media, except for being wanted for his contributions to organized crime. However, we will share all we are able to find about him. El Jorquera's childhood, or his life, before he joined the world of organized crime is not known. He is said to have been a police officer working for the government before joining cartels for drug trafficking and other related crimes. El Jorquera was first associated with the Arellano Felix cartel faction of the Tijuana cartel. He worked under Jorge Briceño López, El Cholo, who was an enforcer for the cartel. Then, when El Cholo was assassinated, El Jorquera moved to the US. El Jorquera then went on ahead to work with the Los Lira, who did all sorts of organized crime, including kidnappings, extortion, and murders. El Jorquera was listed as one of the 10 executioners that carried out organized crimes and had been recycled since the mid-2010s. He was placed on a wanted list for contributing to the increased homicides in the country. The whereabouts of El Jorquera is not known, as there are no reports of his death or capture. What made him join the drug industry? El Jorquera left government work to become a hitman. Why? Well, being a police officer, regardless of the rank and the jurisdiction he was assigned to, it was enough to make huge money. Cartel jobs are usually massive money. Plus, he didn't have to end up being killed while being wretched. Even if he were to get killed as a hitman, he would have made enough to live well. There are no official sources of when he left the government job or how he left. However, there are rumors that he already started to work with cartels while still a police officer. He gave information and help in making their operations without hitches. He finally left his job and became a full-time hitman. His job as a police officer helped him in settling in well in the cartel industry. He started with drug trafficking and then graduated into kidnapping, extortion, and murders. He became head of executions for a group and was wanted by the authorities as one of the executioners that contributed to the increased homicides of some areas in Mexico. What was El Jorquero's experience as a cartel boss? Enrique Jorquera Guerrero, El Jorquera, is known as an enlisted executor in the cartel industry. He was ex-ministerial police who defected and became a henchman for cartels. El Jorquera started by associating with the Arellano Felix cartel, a faction of the Tijuana cartel headed by the Arellano brothers. He worked under the commands of El Cholo, a high-ranking lieutenant in the cartel. He became someone El Cholo came to trust highly because of his work in the cartel, which allowed them to gain relevance in Tijuana. While El Jorquera was working with El Cholo, he became friends with Arzate Aquiles, El Aquiles, the leader of the Los Aquiles. Los Aquiles is a gang that trades in northern Baja California, Tijuana, headed by El Aquiles and his younger brother, La Rana, also his right-hand man. His friendship with El Aquiles was due to the drug trade between El Cholo and El Aquiles when he started in the cartel industry. El Jorquera met up with El Aquiles several times for the drug trade. They ended up becoming friends and associates after El Cholo's assassination. El Jorquera handed El Aquiles over to El Turbo, the head of the group of sicarios of the CAF. He did this because he relocated to the US then. After leaving the CAF, El Jorquera met with the Los Lira in the late 2000s. He started as someone who did transfer work, a job meant for those who worked for the government like the police, ministers, legislators, etc. However, El Jorquera proved to be different from his peers as he became a vital person in the cartel. He began kidnapping, extorting, and killing people, which proved helpful to his bosses. He worked his way up to the ranks to become the head executioner of the Los Lira. He was in charge of transporting drugs and orchestrating murders. The Los Lira is a group formed by the Lira family. The Lira family consists of Alfonso Lira Sotelo, the ex-leader, his brother, Javier Lira Sotelo, El Aníbal, or El Carnicero, and their sister, Delia Lira Sotelo. Los Lira is a cartel group that carries out organized crime. They are set to execute people based on orders given to them in order for a massive amount of money. El Jorquera was said to be their head executioner, who orchestrated the murders. Alfonso Lira Sotelo, alias El Atlante, was arrested in September 2014 by the Mexican authorities, while his brother in 2015. The authorities believe they are involved in organized crime, and through their head executioner, they are directly related to the homicides in Tecate and the metropolitan area with Tijuana. The Lira family in 2016 was designated by the US Department of Treasury's Office for Foreign Assets Control, OFAC, as under the Kingpin Act, which led to their assets in the US being frozen. The Kingpin Act declares a wanted drug lord as the Kingpin, and it is requested that the public don't trade or have any business with them. They were designated for their drug trafficking and money laundering on behalf of the Sinaloa cartel and or its high-ranking members. This, they believed, was done to expand the cartel's operations in California. El Jorquera was reported to have left for the US after the death of El Cholo, his boss. Though in 2017, he was listed as one of the 10 executioners responsible for the increased homicides in places like Mexicali and Tecate in Mexico since 2014. Perhaps his experience and knowledge as ex-ministerial police are what is working in his favor, keeping him hidden from the authorities and the public eye. El Jorquera is a wanted execution, believed to have carried out killings for large cartel syndicates in Mexico. There are reports that he's affiliated with Sinaloa cartel, while others said it is with CAF and CJNG. His whereabouts is unknown for now, despite being credited as an executioner who contributed to homicides for years. What do you think about El Jorquera? Would he return to public space? Let us know what you think in the comment section. Kindly subscribe, hit the notification bell, and follow our social link in the description below.